Hello everyone, my name is Larseth, and welcome back to, I guess, a slightly different, different video. Obviously previously on the channel, I've only ever done, Europa Universalis content. So I thought I'd probably, this is sort of an update video, channel update video, I guess you could call it. Just so I can sort of discuss what I'm doing or what I plan on doing, so on and so forth, with a me doing obviously Icecrown Citadel in the background, trying to get the invincible mount. And I am recording this all live, so if I like get distracted for whatever reason, that is why. But yeah, so I obviously just finished the the Luck of the Irish because campaign in Europa Universalis. And I wasn't, I sort of finished it and then didn't have time to actually start on the next campaign immediately. So I was just sort of like, essentially I was unsure of what, you know, campaign I should start doing. I mean, I've got a choice in mind. It'll probably be something like Old Alliance Reversed. Well, no. I think I discussed possibly not doing Old Alliance Reversed. Purely because it's essentially a repeat of, you know, the campaign I've just done. In the form of, you know, it's based on the British Isles. And spend most of the time looking at the same... I forgot to put my cooldown. Most of your time's looking at the same actual picture, which is the British Isles. The other one's Manchurian Candidate, which is a form of the Manchu. There's loads, but I'll probably try and pick something different, sort of outside of Europe. I imagine. One thing I'm going to do quickly is turn the sound down slightly. It's deafening me. There you go, 10% should be fine. But yeah, so that's probably what I'm going to do for Europa Universalis. I'm still waiting for my part. Wow, there's two parts, my motherboard and my graphics card. I'm still waiting to arrive. Because I bought all my other parts for my new computer. I've got my my processor, the new case, new power supply. What else have I got? I think that was it. I think most other things, like the hard drives and SSDs and the CPU fan, I'm just going to take from my existing computer. But I ordered all these bits probably about 3 weeks ago, and most of them arrived, but then possibly two of them, certainly one of the most important bits, the motherboard and the graphics card, I ordered at the same time. So I got a NVIDIA GTX 170, which only came out on the 8th, I think, at least in the UK it did. I mean, at the moment, most of the editions are Founders editions, so essentially the very first models. And I went for a EVGA version. But unfortunately, I guess the one I went for was quite popular, so I ordered it before it was released, and they sent me a email about a week later going, we tried ordering your thing, but when we asked the warehouse if they had any, they didn't. So they emailed me like, you can update it or just cancel your order, which wasn't ideal, because obviously I would have quite liked to have had it. I should have had it by now, been able to assemble it. But I swapped out for a gigabyte, a same card, but just a gigabyte version, as in the maker. And so I'll be waiting, I imagine. Oh, whoops. Didn't mean to do that. I'll probably be waiting about another week, I imagine, until I get that, because the Gigabyte one is definitely in stock, 100% in stock, so I know I'll be getting that one, but it probably won't be delivered for about a week. This is ridiculous, this fight now. It's literally a One shot. Sometimes you can do it fast enough so you don't have to bother killing these Reavers, but either way, it's still fast. But yeah, in the next week, I should be able to get my, all the parts, and then obviously it's just grown up Lego at that point, assembling them. So I'll get that all together. And the main reason I want to do that is because currently it takes me ages to actually, like, render video. I mean, not too long. I mean, when my Europa Universalis videos, which are anywhere between sort of 20 and 25 minutes normally, take me probably about an hour and a half to 2 hours. Probably an hour and 40 minutes is a good estimate to render. I mean, editing takes no time at all. It's the rendering that's the pain in the ass. So,
let's get a move on then.
I'm hoping. Well, I mean, I know it will. These new parts will speed it up quite significantly, because that's the main reason I haven't done any, like, many other videos. It's like been one a day, Europa Universalis stuff. Just because, like, I get home from work. I normally record three videos at a time, so I'll get home from work, edit and render one, and while I'm doing that, I can't really do a lot else. Like, I can't record any other videos on my PC while I'm doing that, just because it can't handle doing both at the same time. So I have to do that and then upload it. And obviously, while I'm uploading it to YouTube, I can record some more footage if I so wish. But I guess once I've got these parts and I have installed them, etc., etc., then hopefully that should speed up my ability to sort of produce videos. So, I mean, I'm not sure if I'll produce any more than one European Universalis video a day. Reason being is, I mean, obviously, well, I'm speaking for myself here, but generally when I watch them, I can only watch, like, certainly one series at a time. I can't watch multiple series at a time. But I guess that just is down to how people sort of consume information. But yeah, I can't normally do that. So I think if I do any more videos, it's almost certainly just going to be Europa Universalis, and then a few other videos sort of dotted here and there. As to what they will be, I'm not really sure. I mean, as you can see, I obviously play World of Warcraft, and this is just a nice sort of background thing. I mean, pretty much everyone who plays World of Warcraft would have been in here. So it's nothing special by any means. Or it would be if I get invincible at the end, but we'll see. I don't know how long this video is going to last, because it normally takes me about 20 minutes to half an hour. No, probably about half hour to do the whole of this. And it may... Well, I don't particularly want to make the video hideously long. One, because people probably won't watch it anyway. so it's a bit of a waste of time. But thank you very much if you are. It means a lot. But yeah, and it'll also take a frickin' age to render. So what I just put it on to render, I think, when I go out later. And just leave it. I really do need to figure out how to actually get... what's it called? Vegas to turn off the computer after it's finished rendering. I'm almost certain this is a setting you can use to do just that. Haven't really tried to look for it, if I'm honest. But yeah, so I keep, like, going off on small tangents, as is my way, generally. But World of Warcraft videos, I mean, I quite enjoy sort of, making gold videos. Well, not making gold videos. I haven't really done that. I mean, there's one gold video on this channel. It was, like, the first video I ever did, like, back in 2014. Which is, you know... I mean, it still stands. It's still relevant. But I guess I can make gold videos. I quite enjoyed sort of playing the auction house. I mean, at the end of the current, like, expansion, the Warlords of Draenor, I haven't bothered doing any of that for about the last 6-7 months. Purely because the population, the player base in Legion plummeted after about, what, probably about 5 months into the expansion. 6 months into the expansion, just absolutely plummeted. And this most recent patch, it's just gone nuts. Which means that, you know, for me, I mean, most of the stuff I sell is like transmogs. And I'm on, well, originally it was low pop realm, Earthen Ring, on the, obviously on the EU server. And they merged it with Darkmoon Fair, which sort of made it vaguely, I guess it was a medium realm, but it didn't feel like it. It still felt like a low pop realm. And that was before Warlord, so now at this point it feels pretty deserted, to be honest. So I'm just not bothering to actually, you know, sell really much of my transmogs. Plus, what with the transmog system coming out, or the new transmog system coming out in the next few I guess it is days, yeah, because it's the pre-patch drops next Wednesday. So what with the new transmog system coming out then, I might use some of the stuff that I would normally sell and keep that and add it to my inventory, because I've got quite a few rare things. And I mean, being on a small population server, like selling really high value transmogs and recipes and stuff is pretty hard. It can take a long ass time. I mean, I've had stuff for years, I think. I've still got stuff from like beginning of Mr. Pandaria that just haven't sold yet. And I'm sure there are plenty of people who have stuff that's far older than that that they haven't sold, in terms of, you know, when they actually first got it. But I probably will just make some videos. I mean, certainly I know there's that, like in Legion, they're planning to essentially reduce the value of gold. They're just trying to create loads and loads and loads of gold sinks. I mean, there's a new Kirintor ring. I think it's Kirintor. It's one of the Dalaran rings, which is, oh no, it's like that ring of the Kirintor, but it's an updated version. Go away, stupid bugs. Yeah, that's like 200k, I think. There's loads of gold sinks they're putting into the game, basically. Which is good, because like getting gold is becoming silly easy. I mean, you'll see I've got, I mean, it isn't a huge amount, obviously, 250,000. And up until about a week ago, I spent 100 grand on one boost and 30 grand on another boost. So, you know, obviously 130 grand I've spent last week just on that. So I did have a bit more money. But I mean, that's with me not even, like, pretty much the whole of Warlords, I have not bothered really trying to make gold other than just sort of accruing it through dungeons and raids and, like, well, raid finder raids, or like just running these old raids to get mounts. So I do Dragon Soul, well, actually see here on save instances, although, well, I do Icecrown Citadel, I try and do all of the Mr. Pandaria bosses, I do Dragon Soul every week, and all these are on the highest sort of difficulty setting for like Icecrown Dragon Soul, just because it, well, certainly for Dragon Soul, it ups the drop rate of the mounts. I haven't really, money's just so easy to come by, so I'm really happy that they're making it, or they're trying to drain gold from the economy. Having said that, I'm not sure it'll still make really any difference on my realm, just because there's so few people on my realm that you struggle to sell a lot of things anyway, just because not the demand for it, especially when it comes to transmogs and all that good stuff. So I guess I could do some gold videos. As for specific subjects, I don't know. probably maybe a few on, you know, playing the auction house, trades guild master, stuff like that, because that's sort of the thing I know a bit better than, you know, how to do, you know, crafting. I mean, Mr. Pandaria, I made pretty much all my money through crafting, jewel crafting and whatnot. But with Warlords of Draenor having essentially... Oh, no, I'm going the wrong way. I want to go across the middle. Having essentially killed off crafting almost entirely, in my opinion. I mean, obviously, it's still very lucrative if you're really dedicated, but I just think that the whole garrison thing destroyed crafting for me, personally. But... So yeah, I could probably do that. I mean, I know some like nice gold making spots in like the Mr. Pandaria areas, but unfortunately, those to get the best or the largest benefit out of them, or the largest gold return, you should really be using the potions of luck. And I believe I'm right in saying that those are being removed with Legion. Whether it's in the pre-patch or whether it's actual Legion, I'm not sure. But with those being removed, that makes a lot, if I am actually correct and they are being removed, that removes a lot of gold-making opportunities from there. And also, Cataclysm dungeons are being nerfed heavily in terms of how much gold they give. All the garrisons being nerfed, obviously, because that would just be silly leaving it as it is. Because everyone would just stay in their garrisons and earn passive money from the missions. What else? I suppose I could, I mean, like, I'm not a raider by any stretch of the imagination. I've never been in what you would call a sort of a proper raiding guild. I mean, I did like the odd, I think in Mr. Pandaria I did the odd, this is with the exception of pugging, by the way, just in a normal guild group. I did the odd, I think we did, what did we do? It was Mogoshan Vaults. We did some of that on, I can't remember whether it was normal mode or whatever. So yeah, I'm not a raider, so I mean, there's probably not going to be any nice flashy videos of me sort of doing some amazing feat in a raid. I mean, also, you know, PvP, quite fun, but, you know, I'm by no means an aficionado at it. You'll see I've got some of all the Ashran stuff here. And I recently finished off the Nemesis ones. So I sort of, this is what one of those boosts I was talking about was. It was sort of, I guess, a little bit cheaty. Well, it's not cheaty. Basically, I did four of the Nemesis ones, and there were three remaining that I did not have, which were Troll, Goblin, Troll, Goblin, and Panda, which I needed for Warlord of Draenor, the meta achievement. And I realized I did not have enough time left to get it. Like, it could take months to actually get the Panda ones and the Goblin ones. And basically, I just started too late in the expansion, so I took a few months break.
We were all getting along.
So that's the reason why all those appear on the same day, is because I got a boost for the last three of them, which didn't actually take that long at all. It was really, really good. And that was the one that cost me 30k. I think it's like 60k for the whole shebang, I believe it was, for like all seven races, but obviously I only needed three. So that sort of essentially narrows it down to, you've got either videos related to guides, you know, like rep guides or whatever, gold videos. I mean, gold videos are pretty much always, I mean, there are so many people that do them, and obviously they're a lot better than me in terms of, you know, they've got long-standing audiences for this sort of thing. Although there have been a few newer people, like old, well, I say newer, I've still been doing it for a while, but like old Bess, who's done really well with his videos, his gold making videos, or guides, I guess. So I mean, I could do some of those. What other things could I do? I mean, I'm with regards to WoW, certainly I'm quite an opinionated person. And by that I don't mean like I'm one of these sort of elitists who frowns down upon the current state of the game and sort of chastises new players, you know. Or, I mean, I started playing in 2007, so that's towards the end of Burning Crusade. Well, not towards the end, it's about, I think it was about 9 months into Burning Crusade I started playing. So I'm not one of these, you know, I've never raided vanilla or any of this stuff, so I don't have my rose-tinted goggles and likewise. Always reminds me of that of a joke. You know, how do you know? How do you tell if somebody played vanilla WoW? They'll tell you. Which I always gives me a bit of a chuckle. But I guess what other videos? Yeah. So I'm like, with regards to certain things in WoW, like I quite like. I mean. Thinking about different ways that different things within WoW can be sort of adapted. So sort of like how professions could be brought kicking and screaming into the future or into the modern day or something like that. Let's go kill Captain Rupert. So I might make, I could make a few videos about that. I mean, I originally did plan to a long time ago, but essentially I was too chicken. Because, like, I'm also not a very confident person. So doing, like, all of this was a big thing for me. And, I mean, obviously, you know, it's not hardly like I've hit the big time yet. But, like, it's still obviously really enjoyable. So I could do some videos just similar to, I think, I can never pronounce it right, Belilar? Basically sort of opinion-related videos. He does quite a lot of those, and he's very good at them, and that's sort of, from what I can see, one of the main things he's been successful with. So that's good. That's a good thing to do. But outside of WoW, I mean, I'm not sure what other videos. Well, I mean, I have a load of games. I mean, one of the other games I principally play is World of Tanks. Unfortunately, I'm distinctly average. Wow, at the current. Aw, just missed a bloody lift. I mean, at my current state, I've been playing about a year and 3 months, something like that. And I started off, you know, World of Tanks has quite a high learning curve, I guess. So all the good people who are good now sometimes forget just how hard it is to actually start and, like, know all the game mechanics. I mean, it took me about 7 or 8 months. No, probably a little bit longer than that. Probably about 10 months, maybe. Yeah, probably about 10 months is a good one. Until I actually started, you know, paying attention to the proper game mechanics, like spotting and, you know, how armor works and yada yada yada. So originally my WN8, which is sort of, if you don't play World of Tanks, it's a statistical value that represents it's a crude representation of how good or bad a player is. It's a very roundabout, like, at a glance you'll be able to know how much you can rely on a player, essentially. So, like, that'll go from zero, which is, you know, you're probably a bot if you've got zero, or almost certainly a bot, to, like, I think, I'm not sure what the highest is. I'm assuming it's an infinite value, technically, it could be. But, I mean, the highest what's called unicums, who are generally, I'm not sure what the cutoff or the starting or lowest threshold is for being a unicum. I think it might be 2,500, something like that. And then distinctly average is around about, from what I think it's sort of 800-900 is technically classed as average. Although, like, I mean, I before I started paying attention, I was about 500 and something, which is obviously crap. Like, let's not sort of dress it up as something else. It was crap. So I think now I'm about 950 or 60 something. So it's come up a decent amount in the time. I think my recent WNA, so that's the value I've had over the last, I think it's 60 days or 1,000 games, whichever one's, you know, if you have less than 1,000 games, it'd be whatever is over the last 60 days. But I think mine's at 1,200, if I recall, so it's not too bad at all. Like, in comparison to what it was, it's a damn sight better. So I'm slowly getting better, but unfortunately, most of the people who make any YouTube video YouTube videos on it, so like Quickie Baby, Circumflexes, Fosh, or Sir Fosh, I guess, and sort of Mighty Jingles, you know, they're much, obviously, significantly better than me. I think pretty much all of them are unicums out of those four. I think Jingle's the only one who isn't, and he's still, like, twice as good as I am. So, I can't say I'll be displaying any of my World of Tanks works on here anytime soon. I mean, occasionally there'll be, like, one game where, you know, you just outperform your expectations significantly. And you'll normally just, you know, or normally I'll teeter along, I'll, you know, do sort of as my WNA suggests, you know, be average or slightly above average. And then you'll just have one game where you just do really well. You surprise yourself. And there'll obviously be other games where you just crap out and, you know, there are bots doing better than you. So there might be one or two games where I might post one or two games. But you also need to be quite good at commentary for World of Tanks. You need to know quite a lot of, either off by heart or have them to hand, sort of values for armor and all lovely bits and pieces like that. And I just don't know those, to be honest. But we'll see. I might post one or two. It depends. But they'll definitely be one-offs, because I'm not good enough to do it constantly. What other games are there I play? I'm trying to think. Let's have a brainstorm. I mean, there's a lot of games I own. I mean, God. I mean, obviously, with European Universalis, I have Steam. And Steam pretty much just... most people on Steam just have a library full of games they either don't play or never have played. And I'm pretty sure about 20 to 30% of the games I own have never been played on Steam. But, I mean, that's the problem with, like, I play World of Warcraft, takes a lot of time, takes up a lot of time. European Universalis, obviously, takes up a lot of time. Like, each campaign, I mean, the Luck of the Irish one, which comparatively is quite a short campaign in comparison, certainly to the Poland one. And that took me 47 episodes to do. This is an obscene amount of time, if you think about it, in comparison to some other games. I mean, World of Tanks is one of these games where you have to play constantly to be good. I mean, obviously, there's a natural amount of skill, like talent, in some cases, involved. Oh, good. I managed to do it without being flung off. Like, I did this once and I accidentally ran into one of these icy orbs and threw myself off the side. But yeah, so World of Tanks, you sort of have to play constantly and, like, to keep up your skill levels, especially you know, if you're crap like me. So you have to invest a reasonable amount of time. So you just don't have any time left to play other games. Like, I mean, I work full time. So I come home, and then after rendering one video, it's like you don't really have much time left each evening. So that's why, you know, your weekends, I spend my weekends, you know, doing whatever, playing games. You know, like a lot of people, obviously. And then I managed to get some recording in, depending what games I'm playing. But there's not enough time in the day, unfortunately. But I'm sure I could definitely find time for World of Warcraft videos. It's been something I've always wanted to do. I mean, going up to Legion, obviously, Legion drops technically... is it the 30th of August or the 1st of September? I can't remember what it actually drops on. But, I mean, there's definitely some preparation that can be done for that in terms of money and what have you. I mean, to be honest, the thing I'm looking most forward to is the new transport system. Because I don't know if you've noticed, but I've had to walk out about three different times to actually vendor my crap that's in my bags. And pretty much all of this... Wow, you can see there's a huge chunk here. Load of that is transmogs. All my void storage is full. All of my bank is full. And they've got the biggest bags in the game. Like, I literally... This is all the space I have left. And that's only... I've only kept this space out of restraint to stop myself using it. Because I've picked up loads of stuff that I'd probably quite like to keep. And then I just thought, oh, well, I can't. Don't have any space. So I just... It's going to be, like, heaven for me when the patch drops next Wednesday and we get, like, I'm just hoping, well, when I log on, I wonder if it'll be like when you log on, you know, for the anniversaries and you instantly get an achievement. For mine, I'm just expecting it to potentially log on, and because I've got a load of transmogs in my bag, or you might have to have them in your bags for them to unlock, just for it, just a big list of such and such has been unlocked. But that should be, I just cannot wait. I cannot wait to have empty or near empty bags. It will just be so, it'll make me so happy. I don't think I can quite explain. Right, moment of truth. Will I get invincible? Will I heck? No. Damn it. Wishful thinking. What do we get? I think I've already got that. Have I? No, I don't. I think I used to have it, but I might have got rid of it because I ran out of space. That's a dagger. I don't do rogues. I don't do rogues, so we won't worry about that. Yeah, no, the most that is literally Legion. The quality of life changes are the thing I'm looking forward to most in Legion, which might actually be quite sad. Like, I care more about bank space than anything else. I mean, the profession stuff sounds awesome. I mean, I don't think they quite went far enough in terms of changing it, which I guess is a video I could, something I could go into in a video. But yeah, it's pretty sad that my most exciting thing is bag space. But I guess this video, now that I failed hard and didn't get invincible, come on, load. Why aren't you loading? I want to sell my stuff. Open. But yeah, I guess technically I failed hard, given I didn't get invincible, as I would have liked to have gotten. So, I mean, if you've got this far in the video, thank you very, very much for watching. It means a lot. And if you skip through to the end, at least you clicked on the video. But, yeah. I'm just waiting for myself to actually spawn. It would be nice. Okay. Well, this is slightly strange. Why is nothing... Why everything's textureless? Things have no textures. This is a bit weird. Right, I'm going to delete this because I picked this up from a mission earlier. Okay, well, I was going to sell my stuff and say goodbye, but for some reason it doesn't... Oh, are we getting textures? We've got textures. We don't have a mount, though. At the moment, we're invisible. Nope, it's still gone. Okay, might have to do a re-log or something like that. But yeah, if you've made it this far, thank you very, very, very much. If anyone has any sort of comments, like sort of with regarding what videos you want me to do, what videos I have done, etc., please do pop them in the comments below. Sort of any feedback is greatly appreciated, and sort of obviously helps me change up what I actually want to do on the channel. But in the meantime, thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the weekend or whatever day it is when you watch this, and take care.